Hey guys, this is Mark. In this lecture, in this video, we'll build the staple of all programming languages that people, when they start learning them, it is going to be the Hello World application. But rather than making those silly printing out Hello World apps and examples that are very brief and demonstrative but kind of silly, we'll make it a little bit cooler. Not so much cooler, but maybe a little bit more demonstrative, just so you can learn more than just one simple thing from this lecture. I highly recommend starting with this one because the core concept of data binding that exists in UI Builder will be demonstrated in its purest form in this lecture. So let's just jump right into UI Builder and build our Hello World. Now we are in UI Builder. To get started, let's create a new page by moving the mouse over this area, click the New Page button, and give it a name. Let's call it Hello World, of course. So the landing page template is selected by default. That's what we need. Click Create, and the new page is created. Let's change the title to, of course, the Hello World title. And to get started, let's just add some components that we'll use in this demo. Click on this icon right here, get a listing of all your components, and the drag input right on the page. This is going to be the input component. Then we will also need a button. So drag a button right under the input, and right under the button, drag the text component. It's in the general section, drag the text component. Let's change the text font size to be a little bit larger. For this, select the text component, and then in the section called typography, expand it, and select the font size, and let's make it something like 50 pixels. Good. The idea that I would like to implement, and I would like you to follow along, will work as this. So user will type in the text into the input component, press the button, and that whatever you typed in here should just appear in this label. By the way, click the button and let's change the label to say send text to label. Good. So how will this work? The core concept that exists in the UI Builder is data binding, which is the ability to bind the value or a property of a component to a data model, to actually a property in data model. Let's set up data binding just so we can operate with the values that sit in the data model. So here, first of all, select the input component and then click this icon right here to open the events and data binding properties for the label. And in here, these are the events and data binding properties. The data binding property we would like to use in this case is going to be the value logic. And let's call this data binding property input data. So by placing this parameter right here, placing this name of the property into this field, what's going to happen is anytime user types in any value into this input component, the value of it will automatically end up in the data model. And it will automatically change. You don't really need to do anything. It is just automatically there. So you put a value into the input component, that value automatically goes into the data model, and you can access that value programmatically. The data binding for the label right here for this text will also exist. And to access it, click the icon for the logic, and the content logic will have data binding with the name label data. Okay. So in this case, we already have data binding for the input component and for the label component. So whenever user clicks on this button, what we want to do is we want to take the value from the data model that is bound to the input and assign that value in the data model to the property that the label is listening for. So just to remind what these properties are, for the input, it is input data, and for the label, it is label data. And watch what happens when we click this button. Well, first of all, watch what happens when the logic that we need to put to this button. So select the button, click the logic icon, and on click event, we want to add logic. And this logic will go like this. We go into object and get set property in. We will be setting the property in page data because page data is our data model container. So in here, we will set the property label data. And then the value is going to be whatever we have in the input data. So go to object and use this one, get property input data. Once again, which comes from page data. So the logic for this one is actually very straightforward. As you can see, we get the value of input data from page data, and we put that value into the label data property in page data. Very straightforward. And at this point, that's it. It is ready. So let's run this page. Here it is. And then for this one, of course, it is going to be hello world. How about we say hello codeless world? It's much better. Click send text to label. There you go. We have it right here. This is awesome. Okay, so this works. Now, let's make it a little bit more interesting. And to make it more interesting, what we are going to do is notice that the label is listening on label data. How about we bind input to label data as well? Okay, so now both input component and the label are data bound to the same property in page data. And what this means is we can completely get rid of this button and watch what happens now. Of course, we're going to type in hello world. This is working in real time. As you can see, as I'm typing the value into the input component, or if I remove, these changes are automatically replicated in the label. And this is the power of data binding. Because as I'm making changes in the input component, these changes go into the data model. And since label is listening on the same property, it is being updated in real time for the label. Okay. Now, to make it even better, we can show that it is bidirectional. And to do this, let me drag another input component right here. And this input component could also listen on label data. So in this case, what's going to happen is this. Now this will change everywhere. As you can see, both input components are mapped to the same property in the data model, and as a result, I can make these changes, click here, in any of these inputs. Okay, and I think this is a very good example that demonstrates how data binding works and how it works bidirectionally, which is very important to understand when you work with data binding and components in UI Builder. So let's go back to our hello world, just to finish it with hello world. And I think it is a pretty cool way of kind of spicing up the hello world, the traditional hello world, into something that is more visual and just more demonstrative of the capabilities of the system. Thank you for watching this video, guys. And as always, happy codeless coding.